What's going on, guys, and welcome to my channel. This is going to be my first ever video, and I hope you all are having a good day. So today this is going to be my first video, and I will be playing a game known as Last Day on Earth Survival. It's a post-apocalyptic survival game set in the year 2027 or somewhere in the 20s, and it's around 3 years old, the game, and it's available on computers, on iPads, on Android devices, on iOS devices. It takes up about 300 MB to 400 MB worth of space depending on the device. And today I will be teaching you how to play the game, and you guys, my friends and family members who are watching this, give me your review in the comments on what I should improve on and how I did in the explanation part of the things. So let's begin. So in the beginning, this game will give you a selection of servers, so I'm gonna choose server 2 play. So it's going to give you option to customize your character, whether it's going to be a male or female. I'll be a male character. I do not want to be a. And you can customize your hairstyle, skin color, hair color, and keep that way. And I think that does it. You can change your name. So let's do this. Confirm. Yep. So let's begin. So before we actually start with the gameplay, let me explain to you the controls. So on the top left of the screen, you will see the health bar. Now the health bar denotes obviously your health, and it doesn't decrease or anything over time. It remains the same, and as you level up, you might get a skill option. I'll explain that later, to increase your health. Now on the bottom left, you have the auto button. The auto button is basically a skill that is available on the bottom left button. So as you level up, it's one of the active skills. I'll explain that as well. And I'll explain what the auto skill does. Towards the right, on the top, is the D-pad or keypad, I don't know what would you like to call it, but it helps in the movement. And the view of the game is actually top down, because if it was like first person, then you wouldn't be able to see any kind of enemy, zombie or enemy player behind your back. So this is much more easier. Below that, the blue sort of line is actually the experience bar. So as you level up, that basically shows the amount of experience you have. So if I scavenge maybe this wooden log, I gained an XP. So scavenging and killing zombies and animals gives you XP. Above that is the chat button, but you can't actually do anything with it, because you need a radio tower. And beside that is a sort of a menu bar which consists of four buttons. The leftmost is basically the battle pass, but you need to be level 15 to be able to buy it. It's sort of like the Fortnite battle pass. So when you level up, you receive certain rewards. Beside that is the shop sort of place, where they have the obviously the battle pass and the and some starter packs if you are the person who wants to some like waste money on this, because you can just play the game as it is. So there's these different packs of for building, animals, transport, equipment, and then you have the inbox. So the game gives you resources over maybe every 3 or 4 days, maybe some food and water that you can take, or maybe some weapons. Beside that, you have the blueprints button, which is the one which is second from the right. beside the back button, and it's basically all the stuff you know how to build. Now, once you level up, you receive certain amount of points. These are the points right above, and using these points I can learn how to build stuff. So I will use this point, and now I know how to build a spear. So at a certain level you unlock how to build things, so there's a threshold for everything. And also you also have the back button. I like to call it the back button, which shows all of the stuff you have in your inventory, all the stuff that you can hold, and it also shows your hunger and thirst. So usually zombie apocalypse games are only meant on being alive by actually being safe, but not in terms of hunger and thirst. This game focuses not only on your survival in terms of safety, but also your hunger and thirst. Beside that is your star. That star button are your skills that you learn. So there's the active skills that I mentioned. These are the ones on the left, the button on the left. There's four of them, you can read about them. But the auto mode allows you to gather resources and kill enemies automatically. The sneaking one, the button on the right, is the one that helps you in crouching. Passive ones are the ones that affect your gameplay. Like maybe you do stuff faster, maybe you are much more stronger. And temporary are the ones you obtain by trading stuff, selling stuff. Beside that you have the loot button grab button. So the game, when you spawn in, it points you towards a loot stash which you have to loot. We're gonna do that. Yes, so we have found a thick jacket, we'll wear that. It gives you armor. We have some scrap metal, we have some rope, some water, and we have a weapon. To know what you're actually holding in inventory, you just tap on the thing, plant fiber, and it gives you, it's the description of the item. You also have this, and I'm gonna equip that. Yep, now I have a cleaver. Okay. Obviously, the bottom right button is used for crouching, and above that, the button is used to hit enemies. The button which shows all those building materials like the hammer and the chainsaw sort of thing is used to build stuff. Now, the place that you are currently in is where you're gonna be staying for all of the game. So you build your base using this. So you need wood and stuff. I'll explain that. Above that you have the mini map, which shows this the non-player characters around you, and the non-player characters are basically different colors. They're donated according to what they are. Red colors are enemies such as zombies or other players, maybe even wolves. Yellow ones are the ones which are animals, wild animals such as deers, turkeys and foxes. And if you tap on it, it doesn't really enlarge on anything, but it shows what's around you. Beside that you have the settings, which shows your basically shows your settings like your language, the graphics, the noise, the music and all that stuff in basic games. And beside that you can actually make friends, but you require a radio tower. Yeah, so yeah, I'm gonna end the video over here. I think that's enough, because I don't want to waste any of your time if you're in a hurry, and I really don't want to extend this too much. So for now, I hope you learned something, and if you're interested, make sure to like the video and give a comment. And if you really like my content, subscribe, and I will be uploading another video in which I start playing the actual game, so you can play along with me. Peace.